9 lipca 2015 roku Agencja do Spraw Uchodźców ONZ wydała niecodzienny raport o tym, że ponad 4 miliony syryjskich uchodźców przebywa obecnie na terenie Turcji, Libii, Jordanii i Iraku. Łącznie 7 milionów ludzi zostało wysiedlonych. Konsekwencją wojny domowej w Syrii były bombardowania miasta Aleppo, w którym zginęło wielu cywili. Kilka miesięcy później syryjscy uchodźcy stali się gorącym tematem na ustach reporterów z całego świata. Mogliśmy o nich usłyszeć wszędzie.
Refugee program. En calidad de refugiado.
Refugee experience.
To resettle refugees.
Folks who are refugees.
Nic wspólnego z pomocą dla uchodźców.
Refugee ban.
Widzieliśmy obrazy przedstawiające niezliczone fale uchodźców, upakowanych po brzegi w rozpadających się łódkach, przekraczających granice Turcji, Grecji i Włoch, uciekając od terroru i wojny domowej, szukając miejsca, w którym odbudują swoje rodziny i znajdą spokój.
Polacy! Przeciw imigrantom!
Polacy! Przeciw
imigrantom! Polacy! Przeciw imigrantom!
Polacy! Przeciw!
Fakty wyglądają tak, że to islamscy imigranci prowadzą swoistą inwazję kulturową na nasz kontynent.
Przeciwników imigrantów było o 1 punkt procentowy więcej. Niezmienna pozostała liczba zwolenników.
Przeciwnikami relokacji najczęściej są respondenci najmłodsi. To niemal 9 na 10 osób w wieku od 18 do 24 lat.
Kolejny temat, lepiej wyjść z Unii niż przyjąć uchodźców. To zaskakujący wynik najnowszego sondażu przygotowanego przez IGRIS dla Polityk.
Za to 71% badanych odpowiada nie.
W tym roku do Grecji i Włoch przybyło już 100 tysięcy uciekinierów z Bliskiego Wschodu i Afryki Północnej. Międzynarodowe organizacje alarmują, że Europie grozi chaos.
Po 2 latach takiej propagandy ponad 20% Polaków uważa, że terrorysta jest tożsamy z uchodźcą, że to jest to samo pojęcie.
Parlament Europejski pogania rezolucją do szybszej relokacji uchodźców.
So first question, would you or would you not welcome a refugee in your country?
For sure.
Yes, I definitely would.
Yeah, of course. It's human, I think it's human to help, but it's not our duty.
Yes.
Yeah. So.
Yes, if we can, we have to.
I think like, in the news, do you know when they like say how refugee did this,
yeah.
Or Muslim refugee bombs this, it's all like, it's all word manipulation to like make us think a certain way.
So you have to develop those things. You have to develop a willingness to love, a willingness to love yourself first, a willingness not wanting to hurt anybody in a way that you don't want people to hurt you. When you have that willingness to help.
Help me some money for food. You are asking me for food.
Thank
but you have to keep strong here.
Here.
Your smile can be a help. Let's not forget to see each other, hug each other, smile.
I know refugees personally, and a friend of mine is among those too. And I know that he fled from Syria, and I don't know if his family is alive anymore. And I mean, people here just can't understand what it would be like to be bombed and shot on every day.
First of all, media should be free. They can do whatever they want. Of course, it helps the refugees and the media controls over the society. If they show bad, the society will think bad. If they show good, the society will think good.
We're not helping the actual country, we're just letting them come to us, which is bad because it's not sustainable in the long run. Mm-hmm. So what we need to do is obviously help their country first, help them with their education, help rebuild their lives in that country. And then to stop them from coming to us. Obviously, there'll still be refugees that want a better life, but the main thing is to help them and their country.
problem that we generated in their countries, it's our responsibility to treat them and help them get better, safe. Because right now, they're not in a good position. We're seeing a lot of horrors in these countries.
Able to work in this country and, you know, a job that was needed to be filled in this country. As long as they had a job to come to, yes.
It's kind of hard to know where to get honest information from the media from, because there's lots of different sources telling people completely different things.
Because we only get exposed to certain news anyway, so we don't hear about everything that goes around in the world. We get selected what they want to tell us, you know what I mean?
I think one of the messages that London has for the rest of the world is that everyone's welcome here.
You can find sites that will say that the migrants are all terrorists, that they want to kill us, that they'll never mix in our societies. But you'll also see sites where they'll show the horror and what's going on, and tell us that it's really sad, depressing, that kids are being murdered. And like I said earlier, we're all humans in this world, and you know, if something was happening here, we would want people to help us. We have to accept them for them, at least temporarily, and then try to help them go back to the countries and stabilize what's going on there and help redevelop the country that were destroyed.
Breaking in with an update on the rising death toll in the terror attack today in Barcelona, Spain.
The horrific scene playing out in Barcelona. Deadly terror attack, a driver jumping the curb in his van, barreling through the crowd. Children believed to be among the victims tonight.
They were running from a van that plowed into crowds on the street. Police responded quickly and in force.
Just come with me.
A lot of refugees are in terrible situations that you, if you were in their position, you would want to leave from that situation too. And if we don't have that kind of understanding of our fellow human beings, then what are we as human beings anymore?
We get them all in England, don't we?
I think that they discriminate Middle Eastern countries and portray them in such a way that they're scary.
Media shows what they want to show, so you could say yes, but it's not really manipulating, it's just showing what they want to show.
I think we need to help each other in this world.
The world is already a bad place.
Helping dissolve the conflict in the countries they're from theoretically would work, but we all know that's not going to happen anytime soon, because our global leaders are idiots and don't actually want to help with the problem.
If you look at the long-term history of Europe, of maybe not only Europe, but all the world is a story of refugees.
Yes, it's our duty to help them.
Trying to not increase war in their region would be a good start.
If we listen to the media, it's like the refugees are gonna come here and take our job, take our place, blah, 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 blah.
The media does manipulate things, and they only project what they feel is the agenda.
The media does brainwash, it does program, it conditions us to think the way that the people who are in power want us to think. And as a result, we look at the media, and because they feed us only what they want us to know, we don't recognize that there are lots of subliminal messages hidden there, as well as there are another side.
You can provide aid, but from what I've seen, a lot of it is like military presence that can cause anxiety to people in those countries. Because look what's been going on in the Middle East for the past decade. In Afghanistan, Iran, Iraq. You know, the US has a presence there, but has it helped? I really don't know.
All right, thank you very much.
No problem.
Out.
Shining bright above you, night breezes seem to whisper, I love you. Birds singing in the sycamore tree, dream a little dream of me. Say nighty night and kiss me. Just hold me tight and tell me you'll miss me. Why?